Welcome to Word of Faith Church. My name is Pastor Herb Roberts, and this morning we're talking about whatever the cause. Last week, you remember, we talked about whatever we do. It was a commitment to Christ. Are we committed to Christ? Are we willing to follow Him? Question only you can answer. This week, we're talking about the cost that it takes to follow Christ. You wouldn't go to a grocery store and just fill your cart with stuff without checking the cost. I know a lot of us do sales. We want to get the best price possible. Same with cars. You don't go out and buy a brand new car without first checking the cost of that car. Well, Jesus tells us the same thing in Scripture. Don't follow me if you don't want to or if you're not willing to pay the cost. We're going to get into that in our next segment. In the meantime, listen to the Brooklyn Tabernacle Choir. They're going to sing a beautiful song about the cost of following Christ. last week, we said was talking about whatever we do. We were talking about commitment to the one true God. Today, we look at the cost of that commitment. Are you willing to pay that price, whatever the cost? You know, authentic discipleship may exact from us the highest price relationally and the highest price physically as well. Something to think about. So my question to you this morning is, how? How do we calculate that cost? The cost of loving Christ with all of our hearts and our souls. And are we willing to pay the cost? Think about it, long and hard, because our eternal home depends on your decision. Every day, Jesus is calling people to follow him into discipleship, and he reminds us that following Christ is like building a tower, that you don't want to leave half finished because you don't have enough commitment or resources to finish the project. It's like going to war and you realize you don't have enough soldiers to win the battle or defeat the enemy. So he says, Jesus says, be sure to count the cost before you sign on the dotted line for discipleship with Christ, because it's costly. We don't want to sign up blindly and be surprised later when the cost gets very high. In Luke chapter 14, verses 28 through 30 says this. Take a listen.
Intending to build a tower, sitteth not down first, and counteth the cost, whether he have sufficient to finish it. Lest haply, after he hath laid the foundation and is not able to finish it, all that behold it begin to mock him, saying, this man began to build and was not able to finish.
Jesus requires us to be committed up front, to be sold out to the highest possible cost. And we need to be fully aware of what he's saying, what he's telling us here, so that nothing that happens later is going to surprise us, because we have already sold out to the highest cost imaginable. In other words, we don't need to know the specifics of the cost in our own particular case. If the agreement that we sign with Christ says, I am yours, Jesus, at any cost. And it's exactly what these verses were telling us, isn't it? In the film, Paul, the Apostle of Christ, it takes an unflinching look at persecution in the early days of the church. Even the movie's minor characters revealed how dangerous it was to follow Christ in that day. Identifying with Christ often came at a high cost, as they found out. And in much of the world, it's still dangerous to follow Christ. The Apostle John said, mere days before Jesus' crucifixion, that most Israelites were still rejecting him. In verse 37 of John chapter 12, many, even among the leaders, believed. However, in verses 42 and 43, it states they would not openly acknowledge their faith because they loved human praise more than they loved the praise from God. Today, we still face societal pressures and worse, just to keep our faith in Christ hidden. You know something? Whatever the cost, we need to stand together as a people, as a Christian nation, to seek God's approval more than human praise. So in closing this morning, he says this, Jesus says this, if anyone comes to me and does not hate his father and his mother, wife and children, and brothers and sisters, yes, even his own life, and Jesus used the word hate, he cannot be my disciple. He goes on to say, whoever does not bear his own cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. Now, this is extreme language, I agree. But I think he's using it to show the degree of cost that we may have to pay is very extreme. The first extreme language that he used, I am calling you to something that is going to look like hatred of your wife and your children and your parents. And the second extreme language he used was, I am calling you to get on the cross, which means a willingness to die an excruciating death if need be. So listen to what I'm saying here this morning. The what whatever the cost means to means counting the cost, accounting the cost of discipleship, the cost of following Christ to the cross. It means realizing that authentic discipleship may exact from us the highest price relationally and the highest price physically. The question is, am I willing? Are you willing? Have you ever thought about it? What it may cost us to serve Christ. I feel today's events, the way they are, it's time to think about it. Seriously, whatever the cost. It's prayer time. Bow your head. Father, forgive my lackadaisical attitude about what it costs you to save me. And forgive me for just thinking I'm saved without thinking about what it may cost me. I recommit my life to you today, Lord, fully aware of the price, fully aware of the cost of the cross. I am signed on to follow you wherever you lead, whatever you have for me in the days ahead. I am yours. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, if you're not a Christian, you don't have to worry about paying no cost or commitment. It's not up to you. It's not something you have to worry about. But if you feel you're being led by Christ, by the Spirit of God, to be sold out, to pay whatever the cost is, then I got a little prayer for you. But you got to mean it in your heart. You got to be wanting it in your heart. Your spirit's got to be begging you, I want Jesus. If he does, then you say this prayer. Mean it in your heart. It goes like this. Called the sinner's prayer. Father, I know I'm a sinner. And the best way, Lord, that I could possibly imagine, because I don't know, but I open the door to my heart. And I want you to come in and live there. I want you to clean out, Lord, the filth and the disgust that is called sin in my life. Change me, turn me around, head me in the right direction. Father, I want to become a child of God this morning. I want to live for you. No matter what the cost, I want to pay that price. I'm willing to pay that price. Forgive me of my sins. Take me to heaven when I die. Now, if you said that prayer, leave me a little comment in the comment section. And if you like the messages and want to continue, subscribe. Just hit that red button down there and subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much. And remember, commitment to Christ is one thing. But paying the cost is an entirely different subject. It's an entirely different aspect of following Christ. And we need to consider, are you willing to pay the price? We'll see you next week. God bless. Have a great week.